We're going to create the seat object first. Go to the left viewport and start creating a line. From this point, then click in here and in here until we have roughly 5 points to form the bottom curve. So at total, we only have 7 points or vertices for now. Add extrude modifier and set the amount roughly at this position, at 14 centimeters. My object has back face cooling turned on, which is not helping at the moment, so I will turn it off for now. And I will make it see-through object by pressing shortcut Alt-X, so we can see the reference images behind the object. Okay, now convert the object to an editable poly object. Select this edge and hit loop. This will select the entire edges at this side. Press shift and drag this to side. Scale it down and rotate it so it looks about like so. Keep adjusting until you see fit with the reference image. Now go to the left viewport and notice the vertices are starting to running off from the reference. Move this so it's located in here. And adjust these vertices also so they spread more, as the upper line will be straight line. Go to the front viewport again. Go to the edge mode and shift move these edges again. Go to the left viewport and fix them again so they line up with the side reference image. Now, we want this vertex to be in here because we're going to have a stitches running from here to here later on. Go back to front viewport again and fix the X coordinate of these new vertices so they are lined up with the reference image. Next, go to the top viewport and make sure the vertices line up and flowing naturally. We can see the front area is actually curved a bit to the back side. Okay, I think we have a good enough base model. Press Alt-X again to turn off see-through mode and add symmetry modifier and set the axis to Z. Convert the object to an editable poly object again to flatten the modifier stack. Add shell modifier. Turn on straighten corner option down here. Make the outer amount to 0 and go to the front viewport and find a good value for our inner amount. You may need to turn on the see-through mode again. We need to get the thickness to roughly this line. I think I will use 5 cm as it will shrink down a bit when we apply norms later on. Now notice this area sticking out like this. This is due to the shell modifier having trouble with the vertex that only have two edges on it and form almost straight line. To fix this, go back to the editable poly stack again, go to the edge mode, create and click drag from this vertex to this vertex. We do this also with the left side. Convert the object to an editable poly object again. Now, if you look at our photo reference, this area is actually a bit bigger. And also, this part is slightly moved back a bit. So, to do that with our model, we're going to add new edges in this area. And we're going to use paint connect function in the ribbon interface. Go to the ribbon, modeling, edit, and paint connect. I actually have this already in a custom shortcut. Now, just draw lines from here to roughly follow this line until the front area. Go to vertex mode and tweak these vertices so they look a bit bulkier. Okay, now we make this line move back a bit. Just keep tweaking them around until you're satisfied with the result. Next, we add symmetry modifier. Then convert it again to an editable poly object. Right now, if we apply norms, we can see that the model is almost finished. But notice this area is too rounded. We need to make it a bit sharper. To do that, turn off the norms again and select one edge in here and hit ring. Use connect setting and slide it so it's almost touching these existing edges. These close together edges will make sharper corner when norms apply to them. Next, if we see our photo reference again, we can see this area is a bit bulge. To simulate it, again choose an edge in here, ring and connect. Center the edges. Click the OK button. Now we want to move these vertices in this edges selection. To convert the edge selection to vertex selection, press and hold Ctrl and click this vertex selection button. Now the vertices are selected based on the edge selection before. Go to the move mode and make sure it is set to local and move these along the local Z coordinate so they are protruding a bit from the original surface level. Now, in some 3ds Max versions, you may experience errors when moving vertices in local Z-coordinates. If that ever happens to you, there is a workaround for this. While the vertices are selected, apply a push modifier. The modifier will be affecting only these vertices that we select before. And notice, when we increase the push value, it will protrude them out of the surface. Roughly about 1.2 cm will do. Convert the object to an editable poly object again and apply norms to it. Now, if you are creating a 3D model that will be placed near or close to the camera, you might want to increase the norms iteration to 2. For this tutorial purpose only, I will only use 1, just to make things more simple and fast. Save the file with the incremental numbering just to play safe. In the next video, we're going to create the stitches and add the leg to our chair model.